Hello?
Hello. Who is this?
This is the Queen of England. Oh, Prickle, even in London we've heard of your greatness. Someone has stolen the crown jewels, and we need you to find the person who did it.
Oh, okay. Why do you
Can
need...
Can you bring the magnificent horse, Pokey, too?
Sure, but...
Oh, Prickle, you can't believe how glad we are. All expenses will be paid by me. Goodbye, Prickle.
See ya. Dad. Yes, son? I'm going to London. Oh, another adventure? Yeah. A Neapolitan milkshake with ice cream. Pokey, you want to go to London?
London? Do I have to pay anything?
Nope.
Well then, what are we waiting for?
Boy, it almost feels like we aren't flying.
I know. It's a nice private jet, isn't it?
Yeah. Wait, where'd you get the money to buy?
Oh, it's a menu. I'm going to order a prime rib with a double side of caviar and a Caesar salad and 2 tons of fresh turnips.
I'm just going to have an apple with an oatmeal milkshake.
What's this? Oh, it's a paper with the Queen's signature.
What does the Queen have to do with all this?
Just trying to find someone who stole the crown jewels for the Queen. It's a need-to-know basis, and you don't need to know.
The paper with the Queen's signature?
Here you go.
The limo's that way.
Thank you.
No problem. No problem at all.
Hello, Your Majesty. This is Pokey.
Oh, I know. I've seen him on the telly.
The TV?
Oh, pish-posh. Prickle, you just have to find out who stole the crown jewels. I will provide first-class travel to the Tower of London so you can investigate.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
How'd they get in here? There's no sign of forced entry.
They slipped in.
Slipped?
They squeezed through the space between the door and the wall.
Who could do that?
Someone thinner than paper, or someone flexible enough to make themselves thinner than paper.
Who could that be?
Pokey, we are looking for a clay person.
Now, how'd you figure that out?
Just skill, man. Just skill.
What did you find out at the scene of the crime?
We found out that the person we are looking for is made out of clay.
Dear the Queen of England, it seems I may have stolen the crown jewels. If you provide me with £1 billion, I will gladly give them back. From Monterey Jack.
Oh dear! It's a message from that horrid thief! What do you make of it, Prickle?
Where'd you get that magnifying glass?
Just skill, man. Just skill.
That didn't answer my question.
This person's writing is a bit messy. Typical for someone made out of clay.
Why don't you check for fingerprints?
Someone made out of clay has no fingerprints.
I see.
The return address, 7256 Oven Street. Come on, Pokey.
Prickle, it's getting dark. We won't be able to catch the criminal by then.
All right, fine. Your Majesty, where will we be staying?
You'll be staying at 221B Baker Street.
Isn't that where Sherlock Holmes lived?
He didn't live there, Pokey. He's a fictional character.
What? This must have been Sherlock Holmes' home. Look, there's a violin, and there's even a lot of books.
A respectable establishment should have many books, and the person who lived here before us may have simply been a violinist.
And the person who lived here before us was Sherlock Holmes.
Sherlock Holmes isn't the only person in the world who can play the violin.
I've never seen you play the violin before. How'd you get so good at it?
Just skill, man. Just skill.
Well, I'm going to sleep.
It's going to be a big day tomorrow, so I'll get some sleep too. The game is afoot.
Huh? What game? Whose foot?
There he is, Monterey Jack. Where could he have gone?
I think he went that way.
So many stairs.
Pokey, you go that way, and I'll go the other way.
You sure it's a good idea to split up?
I'm sure. Now go! Never find out where the crown jewels are.
Gumby?
No, I'm not Gumby. I am Monterey Jack. And you, my friend, are in a difficult position. Hello, Prickle. Welcome to my flat.
Doesn't look too flat to me.
No, it's, my apartment.
Oh, why is it called a flat?
How many lumps, Prickle? I'm not going to have any sugar cubes. I'm not going to drink it anyway. It's probably poison.
What? That's ridiculous. I have no reason to poison you.
Well, I'm still not going to have any tea. Pokey?
Sure. I'll have some tea.
Not bad.
Ta-ta! I'm about to make £1 billion.
All right. What's our plan now, Prickle?
I don't know.
What? Are you giving up?
I don't know. Maybe.
What? You don't give up. Did you give up when Gumby was frozen in that book about the moon?
No, but I mean...
Did you give up when we were trapped in a hotel in Mexico?
No.
No, you don't give up. You are Prickle, the Prickle. And you're a pretty great detective, too.
You're right. What am I doing? All right, how do I untie these ropes?
Use your fire breath.
Fire breath? I don't think I can.
Come on!
All right, I'll try.
Yippee!
Now, how to get out of here?
The door?
The door's locked.
Ah, the window.
That's a long ways down. The tablecloth. Think you can climb down?
Sure.
Wait.
Your Majesty, first...
You're Gumby!
That's right. I've been pretending to be someone else all along. Now give me £1 billion and you can have your crown jewels.
All right, fine.
Get the check. Guard, we need to get inside. We need the paper with the queen's signature. Where is it?
Wait.
Sign it.
Ah, here it is. See, it has the queen's signature.
Don't sign anything.
I know where the crown jewels are. They are in an apartment on 5562 Cooking Street.
Thank you for that wonderful performance, my old friend.
Don't listen to him. He's not Gumby.
Guards! Arrest Monterey Jack! Sir Pickle.
That was a nice vacation. We got to see Buckingham Palace, Big Ben, and I got to drink tea in London.
Yeah, that's true. I guess it was more like a vacation than I thought. But then again, we had to solve a mystery, got kidnapped by a random person who looks like Gumby, and had to climb 334 stairs.
Just a normal day for us.